Good afternoon, guys. I fixed my dad's truck. It was the catalytic converters. It was only one of them, but I went on ahead and got the back two removed. What had happened was the front catalytic converter, somehow it just all turned into powder. I guess something got clogged in and it got too hot, and it all turned into powder, and it went and blocked the back catalytic converter. But what I did was, I went and got this little grinder here and like cut a little slip in it, so it could breathe in both of the pipes, like right before the back cat, so that it could breathe. And I was able to drive it to the muffler shop about 20 or 30 minutes away, and we got it taken care of, got both of the back cats deleted, and I guess the front one gutted itself. The front passenger side, it gutted itself, and we didn't get the other one, so it's all fine now. We don't have no check engine light or anything like that, so I'm gonna park this in the shade so it won't be hot as heck when I get in it here later on, parking the carport, and we'll go for a ride in my dad's truck. Shoot, it's hot in here. And yeah, I don't have the when I did the rev on my truck last time, I had resonators on it. Couldn't do that for long. I had to take them off, so it sounds like a drag truck. But when I get some more gas in it, we'll go for a ride in this later. I ain't got much gas in there right now. Ooh, the air conditioner's trying to cool it down though. I'm glad I have air conditioning in this truck. Most trucks like this don't have the air conditioner. Like all my friends, their air conditioners does not work. It's hot. But yeah, my dad's truck's running a lot better. Air on for a minute, let it cool down off in here. I'll give y'all a chair what the exhaust sounds like and what it looks like. It's not connected to the back. The back pipes are disconnected. Show you the engine real quick. I washed it yesterday. Got it all cleaned up and shining under here. Looks amazing. But that's not what we're focused on today. Now to the main event, my dad's truck. I know it's nice and cool in there because I got the AC going. Just had a little birdie come to mind. Since I had my grandpa's grinder, had a little light bulb above my head, tell me to go outside and cut right before the back cats, so that the truck could breathe. I had a feeling that's what was wrong with it, was the catalytic converters. They say Nissan has bad cats and they mess up. So that's what I went and did. Took me about 5 minutes because I didn't have a cutting wheel. It's actually a grinding, to where you clean like the parts where you cut welds off the pipes and stuff, but you grind it down so it's all smooth. That's what I used. It wasn't a cutting wheel. So it took me a little bit. But yeah, got the job done. Something that would have cost about 500 to maybe $1,000. Only cost me $80. Well, it cost my dad $80, not me. Feels good to fix stuff. So we're gonna drive it around because it hasn't been driven in like I don't know how long. It's been sitting since the last time I drove it and did a YouTube video of when it was clogged up and wouldn't go over 20 to 30 miles per hour. But now it runs like a champ. Sounds good too. I might get on the highway and do an open throttle. I don't know yet. I'm just glad it's up and running. Cause I know my dad was all stressed out about it. It actually sounds good. It's louder. It's quite a bit louder. Layton's home, I think. Yeah, he is home. No text from him, because I'm pretty sure his girlfriend's gonna come over here in a minute. So I ain't gonna bother him. I need another lake day like I had last weekend. We went to the lake, went skiing, drunk a little bit, had a good time. Really good time. One of the best times I had in a while. It's been a minute since I had good times like that. Seems to have better gas mileage too. I'm surprised the engine light isn't on, because one of the front cats is hollowed, and there's like nothing stopping like that bad exhaust gas from getting through to that sensor, so that's pretty surprising. But I'm glad there's no engine light there. Maybe it reset itself when I was messing with the dang battery cable, who knows? Or maybe the problem's kind of fixed, semi-fixed, I don't know. But the truck runs great. A lot better than it did. I don't think all the power is still there, but it runs a lot better. I think I might drive to my grandma's. Yeah, that sounds like a plan. Just for a little bit. I need to use some gas. It's been sitting up. Plus, I need to talk to him about some stuff that my younger cousin said on Facebook. Pissed me off. You don't put family matters on Facebook. I don't care how mad you are. That's bullshit. So I'm going to go over here and talk to them about that. I told my aunt, which is his mom, and she wasn't too happy about it. I think she beat him. I think he got a spanking for it. Which he needed. But anyways, trucks run amazing. I used to couldn't gas on or do anything, now I can. Up and goes pretty good. Like I said, still not like all the power's not there, but a great percentage of it is. Let's see if anybody's over this hill before I do it. Oh shoot, I forgot that bad tire's still on here and I'm driving it. I know these roads are probably hot too. Gas when I get in the shade. past A. Yes, it runs pretty good now. All right, guys, I'll catch you later. Truck's back. Ain't got to worry about no financial problems about the truck. Ain't got to spend $500 to $600 on new Kelly converters. We're all good in the neighborhood. So, subscribe for content. Drop a like on this video if you enjoyed it. Keep it real and always remember, Jesus loves you. Peace out.